Hello, dear school teachers. I hope you're having a nice time. And we were have been discussing about work education and different aspects of work education. You all must be familiar about the kind of work education activities you have and what's the importance of work education in the general life of or the general educational life of the school. Today we are going to discuss about role of community in work education. Here, let me just introduce myself. I am Dr. Sonal Chhabra. I am from Rawal College of Education. And I'm going to talk more about it, that what is the role of community in work education. As has been discussed earlier in different sessions, work education is something which brings the society or the community nearer to the school. And it's for the benefit of the community and it's for the benefit of the society that we want that the children should be engaging in some kind of physical labor and be involved in work education. So, I don't mean to say that it's just only for the society that we want work education to be there. It's for the benefit of the children themselves also, but then definitely it is helping the community also, it is helping the society also. Now, if we want that work education should be beneficial to the society, we also need to garner support from the community so that the work education becomes successful. So, it's this aspect which we are going to discuss today, that what is the role of community in work education. How as a community, the community can support the school in providing a curriculum for the work education or providing a conducive environment for the work education. Let's understand that what does word community says or what does word community means. Community is a group of people which is residing at a particular place and which fulfills its daily needs from the sources which are available equally and they are interdependent on each other. So, from the definition one can see that it's basically a group of people who are staying together in a particular area and they are sharing some kind of resources, some resources they are sharing and the others may be individually available to the family or the people living there. But these resources are shared in such a manner that the community becomes inter-involved or interdependent on each other. Now, let's just take an example. If there is this section of, let's say, 100 families which are living in an apartment and they are sharing that common green area which they have and they are probably sharing the guard which they have and they are probably sharing the clubhouse which they have. So, that becomes a community. Now, that's one example of a community. And in simpler terms and on a lower scale if we understand, even if there are 10 families in a village which are living together and they are obviously sharing some kind of things, they form a community. So, community can be as large as something like an apartment which is consisting of 100 families and it can be as small as 10 to 15 families which are living in or unknowingly all the people are connected with a common cause. So, there would be some common cause which is associated with all the people who are forming up a community. The common cause could be better living, common cause could be having a better education system or common cause could be having a basic security, so or enjoying a normal life. So, for all these reasons, they have certain kind of common cause and that's why they all together form a community. Now, we need to see that how community contributes to the school to understand the work education or to aid to the work education. Also, there is a contribution by school to the society which is happening. Now, let's see whether we first want to understand that how does school contribute to the society or how does communities contribute to the society or contribute to the school. Now, once you want that work education should be there, we also need to understand that work education cannot happen in a vacuum. It cannot be happen that only a school is there and it is implementing a work education system. If the work education has to be there, it has to be, there have to be contributions from the society, there have to be contributions from the immediate community in which the school is located and which also comprises of the contribution of the parents also. So, that's how Mahatma Gandhi explained that if any new social system has to be established through education, they both of them can't survive separately. Now, that holds true for work education also, that if any kind of system I want to establish, it cannot happen that the system raised separately and the social education system remains separately. They both have to combine together, they both have to work together and only then they will be able to survive. So, for benefit of each other, work education is benefiting the society equally as the society is helping in the work education system. So, both these factors are interdependent and contributing to each other. Now, if we want that community should be involved or how community should be involved, then we need to understand that there are certain kind of expectations which the school has from the community. First is that the school wants that there should be some kind of attendance which should be ensured of the child. Now, it cannot happen that the child is coming to the school once a week or probably twice a week, and then we expect that he or she is going to learn or he or she is going to contribute to the work education also. So, for that system, the school wants that there should be regular attendance. If not 100% attendance, but at least there should be a regular attendance. Once in a while, if the child is taking an off, it's something different. But otherwise, more or less, the child should be coming regularly to the school. Now, why when we say that it's an expectation from the community? Because it's going to be the community which is going to ensure that the school is coming, the child is coming to the school regularly. Now, if the community is not able to ensure that, you're cutting down on the first basic principle of the contribution of the society to the school education or to the work education. Also, due attention should be paid for their punctuality towards school. If the school starts at 9, the children should reach at 9, if not at 8:45. So, it shouldn't happen that the children are coming in just, they may have woken up late and so they are coming to the school late. That's not the way the school should be happening or the work education can happen or the way the community, the ideal community should be contributing to the school. Parents should develop that kind of punctuality, feeling or habit among the children, and then they should be coming to the school regularly. Similarly, they need to enhance their partnership in the educational process of the school. Now, how the community can do that is that they can do that by monitoring the educational processes of the school. We all know that there are village education committees or school management committees which have been formed in different setups in different schools, wherein there are total avenues are available where the society or the community can engage in and monitor the processes which are going on in the school. So, whatever educational processes are happening in the school, if the SMC is there, they are keeping a check on it that how are these being done, and they may give suggestions also on the same. Now, in government setups, it is taking the form of village education committees or school management committees. But even in the public schools or the private schools, as they are generally known as, there are school teams, or there are school parents teams who have an active role, and they play a contributing role to the management of the society and to the general working of the school also. So, if they are given that chance and then they are contributing productively to it, that is one expectation which the school has from the community, and that's going to enrich the process of work education. Also, they can give suggestions in selecting activities related to work education. Now, you all are familiar that work education has an umbrella of activities which are under its purview. You have candle making, you have gardening, you have pottery, and you have everything else. There are lots of things which comes under the work education. So, the community here can help by providing that these kind of activities would be more suitable. So, they can give suggestions in selecting the activities. So, every school cannot do all the activities which are possible. So, they would have to sift out that what activities they want to do and what activities they would have to leave. So, that is going to be the role of community, that they can help in that selection of activities also. Also, they can present their opinion about deciding need and time for work education in the timetable. The way we said that the school management committees are there, in which the parents are there, then they can play a role not just in monitoring the process or in suggesting activities or selecting activities. They can also even help out in the timetable formation, that where can we place these activities. Now, let's say just taking for an example, suppose we are taking pottery in a school and we intend to teach the children how to make diyas out of the mud or the clay which is available around. Now, what is going to be the best time for it? Probably the parents can suggest that if it's happening somewhere around Diwali, it's going to be something which is going to interest the children even more. So, now that's how the community can help in even deciding the timetable, because that's from this we can understand they are getting down to the daily transaction of the work education also in the school curriculum. It's not just about sitting at the backside or sitting on the top and then just directing about things or just suggesting things. If they are getting down to this level also, then they are contributing more to the work education system of the school. Also, they can contribute actively in founding a lab for the work education. Now, we all know that it certainly needs a kind of laboratory arrangement, and the community can help in the school for creating that kind of work education environment in the school also. If the school doesn't have that kind of resources, even the community can contribute something in that form. I mean, there may be a panchayat ghar in the village area, and there is one separate room which is there, which is lying idle. So the community can give that room or help that school with giving that room for that purpose, and then they can arrange a community work education lab in that kind of setting or in that kind of room. So that's going to be the active contribution of the community in the school, and that's why the school is going to expect more from the community, and they're going to find that there can be different 100 ways in how the community can contribute to the school. Also, they can cooperate in the exhibition of the activities. Now, these are some activities, or these are some exhibitions which are very popular these days, and there are a number of schools which are engaging in these kind of activities, that they let the children produce certain kind of material in the school during the working hours, during the school hours, and then they put up an exhibition of the same on a larger scale, and then let the parents also see what kind of work education activities the children have done. Here, what can happen is even the parents can contribute more, because they may not limit themselves to just coming and visiting the exhibition or just seeing the exhibition. They may buy certain things also, or they may bring sponsors also from outside, and that can help even more in showcasing what the children are doing in their work education curriculum. Now, this is going to go a two-way thing. That's going to generate certain kind of financial resources for the school also, and plus it also gives a kind of satisfaction to the children also that their work is being appreciated. So now that's how we need to understand that community can be involved by the school in different forms to contribute towards work education. We are discussing about that how the society can contribute to the school education or to the work education. So it's the community which can cooperate in the exhibition of the activities also. Whatever work education activities are being done in the school, and whatever products, small or simple, which are being produced by the school children in the school hours and in the school premises, the school can hold an exhibition of the same, where the parents or the community can help them in doing the same. Now, how they can help is not just visiting and seeing the exhibition, but they can even go a step further by probably buying some of those goods, because if they engage in that kind of activity, that's going to help the child or help the school first. How it's going to help the school? Because it's going to generate certain kind of financial resources for the school. That's one benefit. The other is that it's going to have a positive effect on the child or the children or the individuals who have done certain kind of things or who have produced certain kinds of goods. Why? Because it's going to give them satisfaction that their work was worthy enough to be appreciated by others and to be bought by others. So that's how the both of them are helping each other. That's how the community can contribute towards exhibition of the activities which the school is engaging in the area of work education. Also, they can have an active participation in assessing and evaluating the students. We are not limiting ourselves, or we are not limiting the community to just a suggestive role. We can also involve them in certain kind of assessing activities also, or a certain kind of evaluation activities also in work education. Now, that's the fallacy of our education system, that we cannot have anything only for the sake of having it. We need to associate some form of evaluation with all the activities. So even the work education area has to have certain kind of evaluation patterns which have to be there, and the community can be involved in that also. Now, that's how we have understood that the community can be involved in the work education. But there is another aspect to it, because we were always saying that school and community are interdependent on each other. So now we also need to understand that how can school contribute to the society. So it's not just that the society or the community is contributing to the school, it's also the school which is contributing to the society. How it is happening? There are certain things, they are very simple. That depends on the selection of the work education activities which the school has picked on. If you have picked on things like how to manage the waste or how to compost basic things, now that's going to have an automatic direct effect on the lives of the people of the society. So if these kind of activities are chosen, it's easier to show the direct impact of work education on the children of the society and directly on the society. Now, there are a number of schools who are engaging in these kind of things that they have initially they started with their own school system. There is a school, I won't want to name the school, but they have done this kind of thing that they have placed three kinds of dustbins in their school. And then there is an active waste management unit also which has been established in the school itself. So, it goes a long way in generating that kind of habit among the children. And then obviously, if it's generating that habit among the children, it's going to have an impact on their parents and then on the society also. So, it may be a longer way out, but then it's going to definitely have an impact on the society. And there are certain kind of activities which can have a direct impact also. If you're taking a cleanliness drive in your area, it's going to have a direct impact. So, depending on the kind of activity, the activities may have a direct impact on the society or direct contribution to the society, and there may be an indirect contribution to the society also. Then they may organize interview of certain kind of artisans who are involved in work education, not just work education, they may be people who are doing a lot of handicraft. Now, this is something which needs to be brought to the forefront because there are a number of people who are working at local level and they are not being acknowledged at any stage, and the parents are not aware of them, the community is not aware of them, the children are not aware of them. So, school may locate these people and they may arrange the interviews of these artisans for the children also to be seen by the children, and probably for the larger unit also, probably the parents can be also called for the same. Now, if that's going to happen, then it's going to have a direct interface. The children are also able to appreciate the work of the artisans even more. We may appreciate a painting or we may appreciate some kind of handicraft work which has been done in an exhibition. But once we meet the individual and we understand from their perspective that how do they go about it, the kind of labor which is involved in the same, the kind of time which is being taken by the same, so then we appreciate even more. And that's going to have an effect that the dignity of labor would improve. The kind of respect which we are going to have for these people who are engaging in genuine physical labor is going to improve. So, that's one area or that's one way how the school can contribute to the society. Another way could be that the schools would conduct or could conduct some kind of surveys. Now, what is going to be the purpose of this survey is that they're going to identify the activities which the community wants that should be taken in the school, or the community wants that these kind of activities should be taken up in work education. Because now that's going to be something which is going to help the school prepare in a better manner. Because if you're doing what the community wants or if the community desires, then definitely the contribution of the society or the community is going to be more, and definitely it's going to be more productive. So, for both ways, the surveys work better, and these surveys can be taken out by the school through their children or probably through their teachers also. Also, how can school can contribute to the society is that they should provide its premises for the campaigns. Now, school generally has bigger areas to itself. They have a large infrastructure. Generally, they have a comparatively large infrastructure to it. So, not just limiting the infrastructure to themselves, they can provide these kind of spaces for certain kind of campaigns. Like in, if there is a pulse polio campaign, the school can offer its premise that you can do it in my campaign, my space. And not just provide the infrastructure, but also provide the teaching staff for the help of the same. Because that's going to be something which is going to bring the school and the community closer to each other. Now, if there are parents who have children who are younger than 5 years and they are coming for the polio thing, if they found that the people who are around are more familiar, they feel more comfortable with the setting. And if you move into a setting where you do not find anybody familiar, you do not feel comfortable in that setting. So, that's going to help the school and the society both. So, that's how school can contribute to the society and bring it closer, because you think on those lines and you are helping the society by providing probably your infrastructure or the teaching staff which is available in the school. Then school can also help by arranging some kind of social festivals during those times in the society. Now, there are schools which are doing that kind of thing, that they would have a Diwali Mela in the school, or they would have Christmas carnivals in the school, because that's how again the community is going to come closer to the school. You're making them realize that how they are doing those kind of things, and the school children also learn a lot from these things because they get an opportunity to interact with the society. Otherwise, what happens normally, the interaction of the children is limited to the parents, to the neighbors, and they are just filled with that only. Or probably if somebody has an active social circle, so some friends may be there. But once you're standing in front of a stall in an exhibition, you are interacting with a large number of people in a single day. So that gives that kind of confidence to the children also, and that again brings the school closer to the society also. Also, if the work education pattern goes this way, that the school can inculcate that significance of labor in a way that the children would respect them, that respect the different kind of labor which is there. So, probably in such kind of exhibition, if you are just rewarding somebody who is involved in your class for employees and they are doing some kind of physical labor there. So, then if you are rewarding them, then the other society or the children also realize that that was something which needs to be appreciated. So, there is going to be a significance of labor which is going to be attached with it. And then if that significance or dignity of the labor goes up, automatically the respect towards these individuals who are engaging in these kind of physical labor also goes up. So, that's how it is going to help again the society, and that's going to be one way the school can contribute to the society. Also, the school can play the role of a pioneer in organizing exhibition at local handicraft artwork or these kind of things. So, that's how school is contributing to the society. Now, we need to understand that these are certain very basic steps which the school can take, and they can build on a stronger, healthier, productive, effective relationship with the society. And we will understand that when it comes to work education, it is not just about the school. It's not just about the children who are engaging in work education and they are learning out of it. It's a two-way kind of thing. The school is benefiting from the society and the society is benefiting from the school. But that can happen only if both of them are having a positive relationship with each other and both of them are open to suggestions, open to taking suggestions and open to giving suggestions also. So, if the community has an open mind, an open heart, and they are ready to get involved in daily activities of the school and contribute to the work education system, they are going to help the school in a planning better things. If the school is able to have a survey of the things, that's how the school can connect to the society. If they do a survey of the community and they understand what the society wants, then they can plan their things in a better manner. If the planning is going to be better, the selection of activities is going to be better, the kind or the amount of contribution which a school can have to the normal life of the individuals or to the normal life of the community through the work education can be paramount. So, that depends really on the school, that how seriously they perceive their role to be. If they think that they are just wilding away, they are just giving up education to the children and they are just giving away so-called bookish education to the children, it's going to have a different connotation. The school is going to have a different kind of philosophy. But if the school believes that we engage in work education and we intend to inculcate respect for all the individuals who are there exist in this society, they may be from different stratas of the society, they may be engaging in different kinds of work, but that's going to help the school inculcate in children a particular dignity of labor. Now, if that dignity of labor is there, the respect, the cordialness, the comfortability in the school which is going to be there is going to increase. Not just in the school, even in the society, these kind of things are going to have children who are more comfortable with interacting people from all stratas of society, since they have respect for people who are engaged in different kinds of labor, they themselves don't mind in engaging these kind of physical activities. Now, what happens is generally in our so-called elite schools, the children would feel worry at picking up a broom and cleaning the or sweeping the floor. Now, the same applies or the same thing happens once they are at home also. At home also, if suppose the maid hasn't come for 2 days, what are you going to do? It's not going to happen that you're not going to clean your house. You're going to clean your house in that case if the maid is not coming there. So, if you can do it at your house, you can do it at your school also. Now, that's how the children need to be reared, that they understand these kind of things. There are examples, there are certain examples in certain schools in Japan where they do not have any kind of housekeepers. They do not have any kind of janitors who are there to clean any part of the school, even including even the washrooms. So what is happening in these systems is that the children are being trained and they are engaging in day-to-day cleaning of the school. All things, including washrooms, including serving the food, everything. So that's a part of their day-to-day school life. Now, since it is a part of day-to-day school life and they themselves are engaging in those kind of things, so it doesn't matter to them. And they are very comfortable in picking up such kind of activities once they are grown up also. And we can see the result, the way the things are there. We know that Japan is one of the cleanest places around. At least the attitude of cleanliness is there. So these kind of things go a long way in inculcating the right kind of attitudes among the children also. But just to conclude, we need to understand that work education is possible only if the society, the community, the school, the parents, all of them are involved and all of them understand that they are benefiting the society and they are interdependent and interrelated to each other. That's all for the session. I hope you had a comfortable hearing.